everybody, I'm Chris Sold. This is Derek Ficken, and we're in my office because our Blockbuster studio is like occupied.
In our backup studio.
We're here for 2014-15 totally certified basketball from Panini Americas.
Yes, sir. 5 cards per pack, 4 packs per box.
20 cards per box.
No way. How'd you know that?
Fourth grade. Maybe.
What? Maybe.
I don't know. I don't remember. Third grade? Second grade?
Yeah,
no. I was an advantageous learner.
Look at you, Mr. Smarty Pants.
So I was all about the mathematics.
Yeah. We got some great stuff in this.
4 packs.
Yeah, 4 packs. There's the Epics jersey.
I like to call
cards.
Them Epics.
Epics?
I'm in Texas. Not
you're,
from
oh,
Texas.
Okay.
Epics. Because I got a funny look from Tracy Hacker once when I said that. I'm going to keep it going.
Okay. We got rookie roll call autographs.
We have
photo variations.
I have Taj Gibson.
Taj.
I didn't mean to say it. Taj. Yeah.
We got a lot of cool stuff in here.
There's some etched foil action here, big time. Holy cow.
Yeah, those are the parallels.
I'm going to throw my remnants toward you.
Yeah, we got that.
We'll go pack by pack. You go first.
All right. So we did a case break for Beckett Auctions recently.
He's the voice of Beckett Auctions.
Yeah, and so there were some base cards that were turned over like a hit. Now, would that be considered
a short print?
Yeah.
Possibly? Maybe.
Possibly?
Could be. I don't know.
Not sure. It went live today. Nothing for sure.
He's going to show his cards eventually.
Yeah, eventually. Number to 199, clear cloth.
See, because when you open the case, you don't show all the cards, but on this one, you try to.
That's true. And this one is cool, acetate where the player's picture is.
Ah.
So that's really neat.
I tried not to make a funny there. I totally wanted to.
Yeah.
How about a St. Patrick's Day jersey for Taj Gibson?
This
might have been this was on the back of the pack. Base card, Taj Gibson. Base card, Dirk Nowitzki.
Okay.
I have a red parallel of Gordon Hayward of the Utah Jazz, and the Utah Jazz having green jerseys really messes with my mind.
Why?
They never had green back in the day. So anyway, okay. Great American Heroes, Tim Hardaway, insert card, number 45 in the set. And my first hit in my first pack is an Arvydas Sabonis.
Yeah.
Numbered out of 60. That's a solid looking card there. Select few signatures. Probably because he has select few signatures.
Yeah. That makes sense.
I'm getting more amped up with this tighter quarters here.
I like it. Jared Sollinger, Celtics. John Stockton.
See, that's the Jazz uniform I'm aware of.
Yeah, I remember. Yeah. Aaron Gordon rookie card.
That's the more advanced one. That's what they went to.
Exactly. Numbered out of 149, Dirk Nowitzki.
Oh, yeah.
And another clear cloth, numbered to 199, James Harden.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Alrighty. I have a clear cloth as well, but I'm going to save that for last, as you did.
Of course.
Carmelo Anthony. Scottie Pippen.
Scottie.
Joe Harris, rookie card. Hard to read these foil names on the front. It's not small, but it doesn't jump out at you like on the red parallels of Karl Malone.
The mailman.
How about a clear cloth card? Dwight Howard, part acetate, part mem, part window, part cardboard, part awesome. Numbered out of 299. Dwight Howard, if I didn't say that already.
You didn't.
I thought I did.
You might have.
I don't know. We got like 3 more of these to do after this too, so.
Woohoo! Number to 279. King James.
Did you hear how you had that radio voice going? 279.
Kyrie Irving.
I can't compete with that.
Zach Zebo Randolph.
Zebo.
Enos Kanter.
So when he kneels and puts his head, like his hand to his head, it's like Zeboing.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a little late reference, but I figured
it's
I'd try.
And number to 75, Vlade Divac.
Ooh, wow. How about a whole, like, three-fifths of the pack upside
down?
There
you go.
I don't know if that's going to matter. Probably not. But
probably not. It's okay.
Some products, they've done that, though.
Yeah.
Monta Ellis and Aaron Affalo base cards. A Thaddeus Young purple parallel out of 49.
Very nice.
Boom. A LeBron James card number 11 of number 23. Boom. And an Anderson Varejo Cavaliers jersey card. Varejo?
Varejao.
Oh, jeez. Yeah.
Varejao, sorry.
I'm not a basketball guy either. Out of 199, Anderson.
Very nice.
Mr. Anderson.
Mr. Anderson.
That's what I'm going with in the future.
All right,
he's got funny hair. I can say his name's funny.
Number 249, Carlos Boozer.
He's not.
Another cool thing.
I mean, he is
but
he's not.
Yeah, in this year's set, number to 135, Scottie Pippen, we have
one of those yet.
We have parallels and we have parallel die cuts.
Mm.
So, check that out.
Mm.
Number to 49, Jeff Green. Those are called platinum purple.
It's not easy being green when it's purple.
Paul George and the Velociraptor, Chris Bosh.
My final pack, Dante Exum, Ricky Rubio, Larry Bird, Eric Green. So two of the four are rookie cards.
There you go.
The other two are not, if you could deduce such a thing. DeMarcus Cousins is my clear cloth card out of 199. Boom.
So I like this product. Like I said, broke it
four
earlier.
Packs.
Got some good stuff.
Probably $20 a pack if I had to bet.
Yeah.
Which makes the box under $100, which is an enticing move to me.
Yeah, it's mid to high range.
Because I think this was a six pack box back in the day.
Okay.
At least historically.
Yeah.
I could be wrong, but because I did basketball, now I don't do basketball. Mm-hmm. I think at some point it was, but. Yeah.
But you know. There's plenty of different types of autographs. You have the rookie roll call, which is, I'm pretty sure, on card. And there's a couple other cool on-card autographs from the late 80s, you know, the older
superstars.
Yeah, older guys.
The guys I might know better.
Exactly. John Sally, Bill Laimbeer, guys like that. Yeah, some nice rookie or some nice jersey cards. Yeah, color. The acetate cards are what I like with the clear cloth.
I don't hate them, but I've never historically been a fan of acetates.
Really?
They're different.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't mind it, but
don't overdo it.
My first experience with acetates was like Score Clear mid-90s.
Okay.
They were autographs on acetate, and they faded miserably.
Yeah.
That's always made me leery of anything signed on acetate.
Yeah.
But that was like 20 years ago.
Yeah,
sure, technology's better now.
Of course.
But overall, though, this is a pretty cool product.
Very cool break, yeah.
So what do you think? Any other thoughts or any other basics?
I mean, just be aware of the photo variations in the base set. I'm not too sure yet because we just got the checklist today.
Just compiled it.
Yeah, so we'll kind of study it, research it, check it out, what it's all about. So check out
Beckett.com
for that. Yeah, I was trying to look at markings. I remember seeing a Scottie Pippen base card in the case break where
the texture.
Well, he was in a Bulls jersey, and then he was in a Blazers jersey.
I had a parallel with somebody too. Like also generally rule of thumb on some products.
Here.
Compare your parallels to your base cards, and then you can probably figure out that one of them is not the norm.
Yeah.
So one of them probably isn't the norm.
Yeah.
Here. Probably that one.
Yeah.
Who knows?
So we'll look into it. We'll let you know on Beckett.com, all that good stuff.
We will.
Cheap, shameless plug. Like
for Beckett Radio and Beckett Auctions.
Yeah. Why not? At Beckett Radio, giving away Trish Stratus. PSM cover now.
I forgot to put that in the magazine. I'm gonna give one away there too.
We're just giving away things left and right.
Gonna give you away eventually. Well, 2014-15, totally certified from Panini America. It's out today.
Today, checklist will be up there
tomorrow.
Yeah, it'll be there.
Pricing after that.
2 weeks.
Yeah. So until next time, I'm Chris.
I'm Derek.
And he's not, but he is.
Thanks.
Click, 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 click.